Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the subject Design of Transmission Systems. And this is lecture number 9.9 in DTS. So we are going to solve problem in the multi-speed gearbox design using the PSG design data book. In the earlier lecture, we solved problems on 6-speed, 9-speed and 12-speed gearbox. And in this lecture, we will design an 18-speed gearbox using the PSG design data book. Example number 7, a gearbox is to give 18 speeds for a spindle of a milling machine. The maximum and minimum speed of the spindle are to be around 650 and 35 RPM respectively. Find the speed ratios which will give the desired speed and draw the structural diagram and kinematic arrangement of the drive. So this question was appearing in November 2015 question paper, and we write down the given data. Number of steps Z equal to 18, minimum speed 35 RPM and the maximum speed 650 RPM. And we calculate the progression ratio phi equal to maximum speed by minimum speed to the power 1 by z minus 1. So 650 divided by 35 to the power 1 by 18 minus 1 equal to 1.18. And from the R40 series, the standard progression ratio from R40 series is 1.18 is available. So it is R40 by 4. So this is the R40 series, and this table is available in the page number 7.20 of the PSG design data book, and the progression number, the progression ratio values are 1.10, 1.06, 1.12, it goes up to 9.5 and 10. We have to repeatedly read. So 10, then 10.6, 11.2, 11.8, and then we have to continue up to 95, then we have to start with 100, 106, 112, like that we have to continue in series. That is what the R40 series. Now here 1.18, so our number is 1.18, so it is here, I shaded with the blue color. Then we have to take the speed, so starting from 35 RPM. So 35 is not available, 35.5 is available. So I have shown by a red color star here. So 3.55, you have to read as 35.5. Then every fourth speed you have to take. So from starting from 35.55, 1, 2, 3, 4, 42.5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 50, 1, 2, 3, 4, 60, 1, 2, 3, 4, 71, 1, 2, 3, 4, 85, 1, 2, 3, 4, 100, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 118, 1, 2, 3, 4, 140, 1, 2, 3, 4, 170, 1, 2, 3, 4, 200, 1, 2, 3, 4, 236, 1, 2, 3, 4, 280, 1, 2, 3, 4, 335, 1, 2, 3, 4, 400, 1, 2, 3, 4, 475, 1, 2, 3, 4, 560, 1, 2, 3, 4, 670. So these are all the 18 speeds. So we have to take all the 18 speeds from R40 series for the progression ratio 1.18. Now here the number of stages equal to 3. So we have 3 stage gearbox, and the structural formula is 3 by 3 by 2. So what is the meaning? So the first stage there will be 3 output speed, second stage there will be again 3 into 3, 9 output speed, and the third stage 9 into 2, 18 output speed. Then all the 18 speeds are shown here. So N1, N2 up to N18, 35.5, 42.5, 50 and 60, 71, 85, 100, 118, 140, 170, 200, 236, 280, 335, 400, 475, 560 and 670. These are all the 18 speeds. After preparing the list of 18 speeds, then we have to draw the structural diagram. For the structural diagram, we have to follow the procedure. Draw U plus 1 vertical lines. U is the number of stages. So 3 plus 1, 4 vertical lines at a convenient distance from each other. draw an array of horizontal lines intersecting the vertical lines at a distance of log phi equal to logarithmic of 1.18 from each other. So, you draw the lines using the scale and pencil, either graph sheet or in a ruled paper, you have to draw. Otherwise, you use the pencil and the scale, draw the horizontal line and vertical line, 4 vertical lines and 18 horizontal lines. The number of horizontal lines equal to the number of steps, that is 18 in the gearbox. And the meaning of the structural diagram, it gives number of gears on each shaft and the number of way of transmitting, way of getting the methodology or the way of getting the 18 speeds in the driven shaft. So, the number of gears on one shaft should not be generally more than 3, but in some exceptional cases it may be 4. So, that is the rule for drawing, preparing the structural diagram. Then this is the structural diagram for 18 speed gearbox. So the for lower speed, 12 speed, 9 speed and 6 speed, it is very easy. For 18 speed you have to carefully draw, because the structural diagram and the other diagram, the speed diagram, ray diagram, everything should be identical, so that we can, if we need not once again scratch our mind and draw the separate structural diagram and separate speed diagram. So we carefully draw. So in the first stage, between the shaft 1 and 2, there are 3 output speeds. So 670 is the input speed. There is reduction. All the 3 speeds are reduced and we are getting 3 speeds, 475, 280 and 170. Then for 475, from 475 there are again 3 output speeds. Again the speed are reducing nature. So they are 335, 280 and 236. Then from here 280 there are 3 output speed. Here we have 200, 170 and then 140. And from here we have, that is 170, we have 3 output speed reducing in nature. So this is 118 and 185. So this is, now we have 9 output speed at the end of the second stage. Then in the third stage, if you look at the third stage, at the beginning of the third stage, there are 9 speeds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 speed. For every speed, there will be 2 output speed. So, one is increasing, another one is decreasing. So, one is increasing. I value is greater than 1 and here I value is less than 1. And at the outlet for driven shaft, at the shaft number 4, we are getting 18 speeds. As taken, the values are taken from the R40 series. All the values are printed here and this is the structural diagram for the 18 speed gearbox, and the same structural diagram we can use for preparing the speed chart. So, the speed chart or the ray diagram. So, next we have to draw the speed chart or the ray diagram. Now, draw vertical line 1 greater than the structural diagram. That is the general procedure. When the motor speed is given, you have to draw one more vertical line. Otherwise, the additional vertical line is not required. In this example, the motor speed is not given, so additional vertical line is not required. Draw horizontal lines intersecting the vertical lines at convenient distance. From R40 series, take minimum speed N1 closest to the value given in the problem and write the value N1 to N18. N1, N2, N3 up to N18. So, this already we have taken. We have taken 18 speeds and it is prepared in a table. Here, the motor speed is not given, number of horizontal lines equal to 18. The speed chart gives the information about the transmission ratio of all transmission and the speed value of each gearbox shaft. So, here there are 3 different types of transmission lines possible in the case of speed chart. One is horizontal line. If the line is horizontal, that means I equal to 1. There is no change in the speed. The line is inclined upward, I is greater than 1, that is speed is increasing. And if the line is inclined downward, I is less than 1, that is the speed is decreasing. So, all the 3 different types of lines can be used in this speed chart to represent the transmission ratio between the adjacent shaft. Then, there are some restrictions for drawing the vertical line, horizontal line, inclined line. So, the I maximum, when you have increasing the speed, the maximum value should be 2. And when you have decreasing the speed, the I minimum should be greater than or equal to 0.25. So, the restriction, why we have a restriction? The minimum speed reduction limit, it is 4. So, 1 by 4 equal to 0.25. The minimum speed reduction is limited to 4 to keep the radial dimension of the gearbox within the limit. So, when you have less than 0.25, the overall size of the center distance between the gears, between the shaft will increase, and the overall size of the overall radial size of the gearbox will increase. And the maximum increase in the speed is limited to 2 times. It is due to the limitation of pitch line velocity. When you have higher value of I more than 2, the pitch line velocity will increase, which will give more stress on the gear tooth surface. So these are all the limitations for the transmission ratio. Now we draw the represent the speed diagram or the rear diagram with the transmission ratio. The same structural diagram I am using here, and we are calculating the speed ratio or the transmission ratio. In the first stage, we have 3 reduction speed by 1 divided by 1.41, 1 divided by 2.39, 1 divided by 3.94. So the limitation is 1/4. So all the values are greater than 1/4. And in the second stage, again we are reducing. So the ratio are 1/1.41, 1/1.79, and 1/2.0. And in the third stage, we have both increasing and decreasing. So the increasing by the ratio 2.0 and decreasing by the ratio 1/2.39. So for all the lines in the third stage, so this is the value. And here also for all the decrease in 3 levels, so green color line, blue color line, and red color line. So for all the line, it is 1.41, 1.79, 1/2.0, and similarly here 1.41, 1.79, 2, 1.41, 1.79, and 2. That you have to remember. Then these values are the actual value what we calculated from the speed value. Now we have to standardize. So we have to standardize. For standardizing, we have to refer to the table in the PSG design data book, page number 8.6 to 8.12. So referring to the page number 8.6 to 8.12, we take the standard speed, and the standard speeds are given here. So the standard speeds are 1.41 is available, 1.39 is changed to 2.51, and 3.94 is changed to 3.8, and 1.41 is available, 1.79 is changed to 1.78, and 2 is available, and 2.39 is changed to 2.51. So all these changes are made in the structural, in the speed diagram. Then we have to take the number of teeth. So the table, in the table page number 8.6 to 8.12, we have the standard transmission ratio, as well as we have the number of teeth required for a particular transmission. And the one more thing that we have to consider is, for the first stage, for all the 3 transmissions, we have to take same number of total number of teeth. So I just show the extract of the table in the next slide. So look at this. So we have the transmission ratio 3.98, 2.51, 2.0, 1.78, and 1.41. In the first transmission, shaft 1 to shaft 2, we have 3 transmissions: 3.98, 2.51, and 1.41. So if you look at here, for every transmission, the total number of teeth is equal to 84. And this condition is to be maintained. We have to strictly follow this condition. Then only we can have equal center distance, equal distance between the shaft. For each transmission, when you have different types of different number of teeth, then the fixing the distance between the shaft will be difficult. This is the condition that they have to strictly follow. Similarly, between the shaft 2 and shaft 3, we have the transmission ratio 2.0, 1.78, and 1.41, and we have taken the number of teeth for each transmission, and the total number of teeth equal to 72. And for third stage, shaft 3 to shaft 4, we have 2 transmission, 2.51 and 2.0, so the total number of teeth equal to 66. And this is the extract of the table available in the PSG design data book, page number 8.6 to 8.12, that we have to carefully select based on the availability of the transmission ratio, and we have to see that the total number of teeth are equal for all the transmission in a particular stage of the gearbox. Then based on the number of teeth, then we have to draw the kinematic arrangement, and this is the kinematic arrangement of the 18 speed gearbox. So first shaft 1 to 2, that is the first stage. Shaft 2 to 3, that is the second stage. Shaft 3 to 4, that is the third stage. In the first stage, we have 3 gears, sliding type in the shaft 1 and the standard fixed type in the shaft 2. So when you engage Z1 and Z2, So the condition is Z1 plus Z2 equal to Z3 plus Z4 equal to Z5 plus Z6 equal to 84. And when you engage the blue color pair, the transmission ratio is 1 by 3.94. When you engage the violet color pair, so the ratio is 1 by 1.41. when you engage the red color pair, the ratio is 1 by 2.51. so these are all the three standard transmission ratio for the first stage. Then in the second stage, when you engage the blue color pair, the so the condition is Z7 plus Z8 equal to Z9 plus Z10 equal to Z11 plus Z12 equal to 72, and engaging the blue color pair, the transmission is 1 by 2.0, there is decrease in the speed. Engaging the violet color pair, the transmission is 1 by 1.41, and engaging the red color pair, it is 1 by 1.78. So again, now you look at here, the first, second, third shaft, you are getting 9 different speeds. Then for the third stage, shaft 3 and shaft 4, we have 2 pair. So green color pair and red color pair, and the condition is Z13 plus Z14 is equal to Z15 plus Z16 equal to 66. So by engaging the red color, green color pair, you are getting the transmission ratio 1 by 2.51, and by engaging the Z5 and Z6 red color pair, there is an increase in speed by 2.0, the transmission ratio 2.0. And this is the kinematic arrangement for the 18 speed gearbox. So you remember the kinematic arrangement. So you have in your mind for 6 speed gearbox, 9 speed gearbox, 12 speed gearbox, and then 18 speed gearbox, you have a standard kinematic arrangement. You remember the structural diagram, you remember the kinematic, speed diagram, whatever we have drawn in all the examples. So that you need not try anything new. So you follow the structural diagram, you follow the, you use the same speed diagram, but based on the progression ratio, you take your speed from the R40 series and calculate the transmission ratio and calculate the output speed as per the standard transmission ratio. So we stop here. So with this, I conclude the problem on the gearbox design. We stop here, and these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the YouTube channel, use the videos for your better preparation and score higher mark in the university examination. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. You can contact me for any clarification on the subject. So we'll meet again in another video on the subject, design of transmission system. Until then, bye bye.